At first light, the treasure hunters resume their search for La Plazuela, the Jesuit monastery that Sean believes could be the resting place of the legendary Sacumbaya treasure.
La Maria is behind us, which means La Plazuela should be right on the top of the hill.
Keep your eyes open for snakes, because this is prime snake country.
You see that? There's a straight line right back here. Yeah, right there. Look at that. Look at that.
What are you guys looking at?
Look. See that? This is a wall.
Jack, check this out.
That is man-made, no doubt about it. I think this is definitely part of the wall of the monastery. This might have been an outer wall.
You got to figure, too, there was 2,000 indigenous people living here working.
Right.
So it makes sense that there would be buildings and all kinds of things around the monastery.
Some Jesuit old houses?
Yeah, the monastery wasn't just there by itself. It was a whole community here.
Right.
We've reached what I think is the outer wall of La Plazuela. And at first glance, it looks a lot like the stone ruins at La Maria. But in fact, it's more typical of the Jesuit construction found here on the Bolivian hillsides. The compound layout is classic Jesuit. The living quarters, workrooms, and storehouses are all lower on the slope, while the crypt and the monastery took pride of place at the top of the plateau. So if I'm right, the monastery of La Plazuela should be straight ahead at the top of the slope.
You guys, right there.
Hey, hey, look at that. I bet you this is it. I mean, this has got to be La Plazuela.
Guys, there's adobe walls and structure. It keeps going.
This is definitely a building.
Look at this, it's huge. Boy, this just feels sacred up here, you know?
When I see the actual ruins of La Plazuela for the first time, I just felt like I was transformed back in time, you know? This is the spot. This is where the legend began.
This is the first piece of the puzzle, and hopefully it shows us a trail that leads to a whole host of significant clues to the treasure that we're looking for.
And there's a series of walls and structure that keeps going.
There's no rock.
Yeah.
This is more like that adobe style. La Plazuela is a lot larger than I had anticipated. Unlike the living quarters, the monastery is made up of adobe, probably because it was easier to carry up the hill. Also, it would have been easier to mold into intricate design elements, which is typical of Jesuit architecture. Just think of the history we're walking on right now.
Yeah, we'll find out if there's any voids underneath here.
Yeah, I mean, if we have GPR, magnetometry, resistivity.
We can make quick work of this. If it's $2 billion, it's gonna be a huge vault.
Yeah. Tell you what we should do is sort of do a precursory metal detection across the whole area as much as we can.
Right.
To get us through the first 12 to, you know, 18 inches. And then we'll have a good understanding of what's there. But then after that, we'll bring in the GPR and the high-tech equipment. So, Jack, you and I will go get the outer perimeters.
Okay.
Jeremy, Javi, if you guys will hang here at the sanctuary.
Okay.
And once you've cleared out an area, mark it. Jack. All right, guys, good luck.
The team will cover La Plazuela in sections of 10 square feet, with one group searching the living quarters and storehouses at the periphery of the compound, and the other combing through the center of the monastery.
Hey, Hob, watch out for those rocks, man. There's rattlesnakes up here. There's holes all through there. Snakes are gonna be coming out right now to warm themselves in the morning.
You know, Johnny was here in the early 90s, and they metal detected, but even those metal detectors weren't getting the penetration we're gonna get with these.
Probably limited to a foot, especially with that technology.
Yeah.
That's something that nobody else has done.
Right.
That's a pretty good hit. It's reading in the middle of the screen. That means it should be non-ferrous. Right here. Let's dig a square around here.
It's really stony.
Jeremy, we got a hit. Bring a pick.
Hey, what do you guys got?
Non-ferrous, but you can see we're dealing with a lot of rock.
Let's get this thing out of here.
Jack, just be gentle, you know, kind of pick at it lightly. And
Jack, slow.
Whoa, watch
slow,
your eyes,
slow,
guys.
Slow.
Watch
slow.
Your eyes.
All right, that's good there, Jack. All right, let's pick a little more. There you go.
Maybe it's just in between these two little.
Right there.
Hang on.
Let's dig around it.
Do it slow. There's something in here.
Wow.
No way.
Unbelievable.
It looks to me like it's, I mean, it looks colonial. Somebody wrapped it, stole it, buried it, who knows?
That's not an everyday drinking cup, though. That's pretty ornate.
I can't tell if this is silver or gold. I mean, it's heavy.
It could be gold wash. That was pretty common, actually. Silver, and then they do a gold wash over the top of it. Here, let's wash this down. Yeah, that is definitely silver. Look at this. There's some markings in here. That, to me, looks definitely like an I and an H. And this is a dead spot. It would likely be an S. I've seen a lot of 16th, 17th century artifacts. So as soon as we see these letters, I knew right away this was a ceremonial chalice, because IHS is the official symbol for the Jesuits. So you know what that means?
Yeah.
This is the right spot for the Jesuit monastery at La Pazuela.
I agree. I mean, this definitely could be part of the treasure Sacambaya. Johnny Irwin swears the treasure's here at the Pazuela. And you know what? I think he's right. I think we're holding a piece of it in our hand right now.